Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known by Brian Lee, right here in the city of Memphis. It's in the county sheriff of the state of Tennessee. Today's date is early Monday morning, November 28, 2022, the time 2:21 a.m. First, say thank you to all my fam, my support for all your continued courage, support, continue. Keep myself employed and right here in this Memphis tri-state area. I continue to further my education, more work hours online, continue to pursue my social media studies, being administration, contract, and mark. Pretty time, took a break, going to school in the very near future. I will be going back to more work hours online, continue to pursue my social media studies, being administration, contract, and mark. Now, I'm going to start my Facebook Live. Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known by Shannon, right here in the city of Memphis and the county sheriff. It's in the state of Tennessee. Today's date is early Monday morning, November 28, 2022, the time 2:24 a.m. First day, thank you to all my family, my support for you. Continue, current support, continue to keep myself employed right in Memphis, tri-state area, continue to further my education, more work college online, continue to pursue my social media studies, be administration. Contrary to my preparing time, took a break and going to school. Very near future, I'm going to be going back to Marvel College on the academic team. Pursue my social media studies, be administration. Contrary to my. Now, what you see in front of you is anti-gang, anti-Gnostic, anti-hazing. Also, adversity is how races translated mean against heresies. Saint Irenaeus, the Bishop of Lyon, together with Saint Ignatius, the Bishop of Antioch, together they wrote a 5-volume book titled Adversus Heresies Against Heresies, Refuting Gnosticism, and also the Catholic Church had already refuted all those other heresies. Also, Saint Athanasius, the Bishop of Alexandria, in the year 367 AD, in his 39th Festal letter, Easter letter, banned all non-Christian writing. There were that Gnostic writing is, them Gnostic theologians doing all this writing. And all that stuff they were writing was banned from worship service. So Saint Athanasius, the Bishop of Alexandria, together with all the other bishops in the Catholic Church, they went around and collected all that Gnostic writing and destroyed it. Now, the Nag Hammadi Library, the little farm boy over there in Nag Hammadi, Egypt, outside playing, he found a jar, and inside that jar was some papers wrapped in papers. So the little boy gave what he found to his father, and his father saw what his son had found. he had to try to figure out what to do with what his son had found. But eventually, the scholars at all the colleges and universities around the world, they found out about it. That there was some leftover Nazi writing that didn't get destroyed. So that name in my library, that Nazi writing, it's already been banned and already been refuted. Gnosticism has already been refuted by the Catholic Church, like all those other heresies. And also, Saint Epiphanius of Salamis, the Bishop of Cyprus, wrote a 3-volume book titled Panarean Greek, Panarean Latin, translated meaning bread basket. Scholars have also said that St. Epiphanius of Salamis, Bishop of Cyprus, 3-volume book is also adversary heresies against heresies. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Now, I know I had told everyone. That I had got this, I had broke esoteric into syllables. And so I had to get the definition and the meaning of esoteric. Now, this is what you see in front of you. It's esoteric. Esoteric. Now, this is exoteric. Exoteric. See, that's serious. See, this is what I've been saying over and over again. First of all, you weren't saying anything. I had already told you that. Told you. You're not saying anything. You're just making up stuff. And just going around being violent. It's all he's doing. Just going around being violent. Made up a bunch of lies. And then just going around being violent. Trying to, you know, with anal sex. Now this is not no joke. Or, you know, just trying to, no, this is what these people did in ancient times. This is what people done. They try to pass all this stuff down to this generation. Anal sex. That's what they doing. the Almighty, Vice Lord, Four Corner Hustle, the Almighty, Black Princeton, the Almighty, Black Disciples, Poppy, the Almighty, Mickey Coleman, Crack, Bluefin Black Disciple, the Black Disciple, the Lord, Stone Disciple, 7-Eleven, G Killer. Now I know, you know, that it's early Monday morning. I already know that. I wasn't intending on starting my video at this time in the morning. It was not my intent. But I was, you know, sometimes I get to doing things and I had things to do. Then by the time I got back to the house, you know, get myself together. You know, but I'm still making my video. And let me say this. I know this past Thursday was Thanksgiving here in the United States of America. And so I hope and pray that that everybody, you know, and everybody had a safe and happy Thanksgiving. And so, like I said, I really was intending on starting my video this time of night. But let me go back and say this about all that. Because, see, it's a serious thing. See, all that esoteric, talking about some inside, internal, within, and all that exoteric, external, outside, and without. It's very serious. It's very serious. See, you continue to lie. And you shouldn't take it lightly when I say that other people be lying, because they do. It's like some kind of charade is you trying to play. But like I said, esoteric and exoteric. See, the sorority and the fraternity, the Sohos and the frat bitches, all that hazing. Then they went from the college and university campus to out in the public. Telling the same lie that you've been telling. Yeah, so when you break down esoteric, and when you break down exoteric, and so that's a serious thing. That's the point I want to make. That's a very, very, that's really why I told you. I'm not, look, I ain't took anything off nobody, and I ain't taking nothing off nobody. Making up a bunch of lies so you can go around trying to victimize other men, women, and children, as well as animals. And so, that's a very serious thing. Shouldn't be taken lightly when you say esoteric. It's very serious. Because, like I said, you'd be lying. And shouldn't, like I say, when it comes to esoteric and exoteric, you shouldn't be. You should be cautious. You should. Because, like I say, people be lying. They be lying. And so, like I said, that's what the point I've been wanting to make, I've been trying to make for a long time. That people be lying. And then when they try to lie, they try to victimize other people. And then what ends up happening, people fight back. Which is true. People do fight back. That's the truth. People fight back. And so, you shouldn't misunderstand about saying esoteric and exoteric. It's very serious. Because like I said, first of all, people make choices and decisions. And then you got somebody walking around calling themselves trying to instigate. That's a very, very serious thing. You see, talking about the history of the city of Chicago and talking about all that esoteric and that exoteric, it's very serious. It's very serious. See, that's my dad, Chester Johnson Jr. He passed away in 2012. And that's my mother, Annabelle Johnson. Now, I go and visit my mother every day. Now, my dad, he was the oldest of all my granddad's children. And my grandmama's children, who they both was from Mississippi. And so, Uncle Lemuel Johns, my dad's little brother, was murdered while I was incarcerated. And I haven't forgotten, and I damn sure don't take it. No. And so, Uncle Lemuel, he was the second oldest of my granddad's children and my grandmama's children. Now, my grandmama, she had another son, my Uncle Walter. He was living in Chicago when he passed away. And see, grandma, she had a daughter, and she was living in Chicago to the day she passed away. And grandma had a son who was named James Debo. And he was living in the state of Mississippi up until the day he passed away. and Verdi Jr. And he was living in Chicago up until the day he passed away. See, the history of the city of Chicago is sitting right there in front of you. And see, let me make this clear. See, like I said, people make choices in the city, just like the sorority and the fraternity. When you be talking about esoteric, talking about some hidden knowledge, and then you talking about some exoteric, some public knowledge. See, that was Rudolf Steiner and the Waldorf School. But see, you just be lying. You be making up stuff. See, the bishop and the deacon represent the Catholic Church. There's only one church. The Catholic Church. The Roman Catholic Church. The Eastern Orthodox Catholic Church. The Orient Orthodox Catholic Church. See, claiming all this stuff, it's no need for you to worry about nothing like that. It really ain't. Talking about some esoteric and some exoteric. Yeah, that's one thing, you know, it's very serious. Because you ain't saying nothing. That's the point I've been making. You ain't saying nothing. Just making up something. Just making up lies. That's all they do. And so, like I said, it wasn't my intent to start my video at this time. But like I said, I had, you know, other things. You know, I didn't get back to the house till around about 7:15, something like that. See, you not sometime. See, you try to pretend like you can get away with it. You try to pretend. Just like when you be on your job, be at work, at your place of employment. You try to pretend like you can get away with it. Esoteric. You try to pretend like you can get away with it. Like the state trooper riding around, the sheriff department, the police department, exoteric. See, you think you can get away with it, with lying. And then after you get through, you try to lie. You try to be violent. See, you have to really, really, really understand. You have to really comprehend about a lot of this stuff. See, they've been making up all these damn lies for a very long time. And going around victimizing men, women, and children. Animals. Wildlife. Nature. The environment. Recently, the North Pole and the South Pole. Hell, if they keep going out in space, claiming that the material world is evil, talking about some demiurge. See, when you be talking about that Gnostic, just like it says, the Gnostic, they adopted the term demiurge. But like I said, that Plato and all that Pythagoras and all that, see, that's where it came from. See, a lot of people, I say Black/African-Americans, not like today, but in the past, the majority of Black/African-Americans were uneducated, undereducated, miseducated. And so, you wouldn't know what a prefix and a suffix is being oppressed. You wouldn't know how to count. You know, your behavior, your conduct would be so the lies that people have been telling is just what is just that lie. And what's gonna happen is that you're gonna end up getting your ass killed. Now what's gonna happen? You're gonna get your ass killed. Talking about some esoteric and some exoteric. And going around talking about this, what they call them? Claiming that the word demiurge means artisan or craftsman or craftsman. Or creator. Fashioner or creator. But see, you shouldn't say things like but that's a serious thing. That esoteric and that exoteric is serious. And you should take it serious. But see, the stuff they talking about this, see, that what they was talking about, this hidden knowledge and public knowledge. See, this demiurge supposedly created the whole world. But that demiurge stuff, like I said, the Gnostics, the so-called Gnostics, they adopted the term demiurge. See, so whatever they was talking about some secret knowledge and some hidden knowledge, they adopted the word demiurge. Well, it wasn't my intent, like I said, for, to be honest, it wasn't my intent to do my video this time tonight, but don't let that esoteric and that exoteric influence you. And so, and think about it. When you think of, like, we've been talking about the TV station and the radio station, the company that owns the radio station, the company that owns the TV station, the sorority and the fraternity. You see how serious it is? The Sohos and the frat bitches. See, it's serious. The state trooper riding around, the sheriff department, and the Memphis Police Department. But it's serious. That esoteric and that exoteric, it's serious. It really is. You shouldn't take it lightly. Don't take it like, no, it's serious. Think about it. We've been talking about how the people at the radio station, they be playing all this music. It can be rock and roll. It can be jazz. It can be funk. Then on the rock and roll side, you got all this heavy metal. Got all this stuff out here. on the street. You know, you got all this nonsense that you played in the studio, then recorded it, then had the nerve to tell the people at the radio station to play your music because you said so. The soul hoes and the frat bitches. Yeah. That's what they trying to do. And all that stuff about some anal sex. Oh, man. There ain't no reason for any human being to be influenced by the demiurge. Talking about some esoteric and some exoteric. Don't let nothing that the sorority and fraternity impress you. About ready to get ready to end my video. Before I end my video, I'm gonna get a newspaper. Get an update on the war in the Ukraine. See, all that esoteric and exoteric. See, that's how serious it is. See, when you investigate the war in the Ukraine, when you do an authentic genuine And so, like I said, over at the radio station, the company that owned the radio station and the TV station, the company that owned the TV station. Don't let the sorority and fraternity, you know, make a fool out of you. And the sorority and fraternity be on the East Coast, from the state of Maine all the way down to the state of Florida. I'm trying to do something about the state trooper, trying to do something about the Sheriff Department. And so, So like I said, that war in Ukraine. And so, first of all, don't listen to CNN, don't listen to Fox, because it's all that's over there. The sorority and the fraternity, the souls and the frat bitches. What I'm looking at right now, I was looking at some of the reports on casualties, which is very important. Because the U.S. government is giving money, is giving weapons to the Ukrainians. Now, if you don't know how many casualties they have so far, the United States government estimates that for both sides, total 200,000 casualties. Yep. Like I said, that's why I'm reading the casualties. I don't want you to think I'm just sitting because I'm not. I'm looking at the casualties of the Ukraine war. Yeah, like I said, all this about this esoteric and then exoteric. It's serious. So like I said, it's a lot of things that's you know a result of esoteric and exoteric. So you shouldn't be shocked, you know, you shouldn't be, you know. But I just want to say this, like I said in my previous video, it ain't nothing that I'm going to take. Ain't nothing that I'm taking. See, them police cars riding around, the sheriff riding around, the police cars riding around, state trooper riding around. See? And see, when they cut that esoteric and that exoteric. So, just understand, you know, as long as we got a good understanding, just like on the west side of Chicago, the conservative vice lord walking around, they see that. See, this is what I've been calling, saying over and over again. And so when they see the gangster disciples, the black gangster new breed, and the insane gangster disciples, see, it ain't no reason for you to have any reason for you to see them walking around. Ain't no reason for that. Unless you just don't know how to read. Talking about some damn demiurge. I mean, you know, the black Prince Stones. And, you know, the black disciples, I don't, you know. If you can't read the Mickey Cobras, you say, yeah, ain't no reason for nobody to be saying, talking about no gangster disciple. No black gangster new breed. Ain't no reason for that. They're talking about no insane gangster disciple. Talking about some guy in the 1990s. Nobody got no being here, nothing like that. For no, ain't no reason for that. No reason. But esoteric and exoteric. That's where it come from. But look, I'm gonna have to go ahead and end today's video. I'm gonna come back. Like I said, you know, it wasn't my intent for my start of my video as late as I did. That wasn't my intent, so. You know, but be that it may, I still want to make my video, and you know, I know this past Thursday was Thanksgiving, so again, I just hope and pray that everybody had a safe and happy Thanksgiving. And the football game, and you know, Cowboys won, and if I even say, well, the Bills won, and I think the Vikings won. Yeah, the Vikings. And so, you know, hey, and then, you know, we had the Macy's Parade, Santa Claus at the end of the parade and everything. Pretty nice parade, you know. And then behind it came the Westminster Kennel Club dog show and everything. And the little French Bulldog won the Westminster dog show. I have no comment. I'm not going to even comment, say anything this year. But like I said, I was reading from the Moscow Times, and let me make a quick glance over. But what I was mainly concerned about was the casualties, because being that it's winter time this year, at this time of the year, it's winter time, and I'm gonna take a quick glance at the TAS. Let me look over at military operation in Ukraine. Let's see. And so, like I said, I was looking at the Moscow Times at first, and I'm looking at the Russian news agency, TASS, Russian news agency. So, military operation Ukraine. But being that it's winter time, you know, this is not a time of year where military personnel can be too mobile, because in that part of the world, it's snow. And when it's snow, it's snow. And so, the Russians, you know, they're holding back the so-called Ukrainian offensive, because now that, you know, you got Russian that have annexed a lot of territory, and that's Russia now. And so the Russian military is continuing to hold off and fight, you know, these Ukrainians. Now, see, that's another thing why it's important to see casualties. When you see that the Ukrainians have this amount of casualties, what you want to be on the lookout for is foreigners. Because, see, the Russians, they, you know, fighting a war. And so when you're fighting a war, you see your enemy. And when you see casualties, and when you see the casualties continuing to increase, you don't want to be asking questions like, I know they're having a lot of casualties. And when you have a lot of casualties, you can't be that confident when, you know, in a war, because you're having a lot of casualties. Eventually, it ain't gonna be nobody to fight. But when you keep seeing foreign fighters, that's serious. That's serious. And so, you don't want to never, ever let your guard down and not see the Russians, you know, eventually win this so-called war. Look, I'm going to have to go ahead and end today's video. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Rejecting knowledge. Now, esoteric. exoteric. See, like I tell the conservative vice lords over and over again, see, you ain't got no business seeing no gangster disciples walking around. You ain't got no reason. There's no reason for no black gangster new breed, and it ain't no reason for no insane gangster disciple. So when you see some people online, when you hear some music, when you hear all that stupid stuff, talking about some bloodstone villain, and some limestone, see, that's the reason why. That's the reason why. That's the reason why that so-called Crip gang and the so-called Blood gang, see, that's the reason why. S-O-T-E-R-I-C and X-O-T-E-R-I-C. But I say this, the one for them damn police cars riding around, them state troopers, them sheriff. Riding around in the car, bust your ass, light your ass up. Gonna have to do something about the state trooper. Gonna have to do something about the sheriff. Gonna have to do something about the police. And then gonna show you. I really don't like sitting here calling a tick. Then I got this time of night. One my intent on making no video, but be that it may, I made my video. But ain't nobody getting away with no esoteric and no exoteric. See, this is what I be calling and showing the Black Princeton. That's what I be showing the Mickey Cole. See, that's what I be showing the Black Disciples. See, you ain't see what you, nah, you ain't gonna be seeing that, nah. Just like the war in Ukraine. Talking about some foreign fighters from the United States coming over. Coming over there. Trying to be a smart ass. But I'm going to get ready to end today's video. You've been watching the fight for World Cup? You've been watching the fight for World Cup? It's exciting, ain't it? Seeing all the nations around the world and seeing all the, you know, because they had the women's fight for World Cup and now you have the men's fight for World Cup and, you know, it's pretty exciting. And then you see all the athletes from around the world, you know, competing in football. And what they, you know, soccer, football. And so, it's pretty exciting. It really is. It's pretty exciting. And getting a real, enjoying the games. And unfortunately, Russia wasn't in the fight for World Cup this year. But, you know. But, again, my name is Eric D. Johnson, also known by Shine. I live right here in the city of Memphis, Center County, Sheridan, State of Tennessee. Thank all my fans, my support for the team, Curve support. And until next time, you take care of yourself. And I wish each and every one of you the very best.